marinating. So I'm gonna bring it out and let it set at room temperature for about 40 minutes before I sear it and whack it in the oven. Good morning. Our brisket has marinated overnight, which we've gone over. Now you just need 6 items to get it going in the cooking process, which I'll cover off right now. You just need onion, garlic. Prep these up and peel them ahead of time. It makes things a lot easier. Olive oil, a little bit of Lagos, some tomato paste, Dijon mustard, and a spice mix. All right, in here you just need 2 teaspoons of brown sugar, a little bit of Cajun, which has your paprika, fennel, garlic powder, all that stuff in there, salt, pepper, and that's it. Easy done. The brown sugar in it is just gonna caramelize your onions and make it sweet. Then, number one ingredient, a mango. Just gonna use that for cooking and then get in some beers a little bit later on. It's about 9 o'clock. I'm gonna put my joint on for about 3.5-4 hours. So let's get into it. All right, we're gonna use a roasting tray at a medium heat. And let's prep our onion garlic. It's pretty much gonna be slow cooking. So you wanna make big chunks here. Don't get too carried away. Keep it simple with your onion. Instantly your roasting tray should start to smoke up. That's fine. We're gonna add some olive oil and we're just gonna sear the meat. Nothing too fancy. Just big chunks of your garlic. Right, whack your fan on. It's gonna get smoky. Right, olive oil into your tray. Once that's smoking, dial that down a little bit. We're gonna get a sear on this brisket. Lay away. Right. You want to make sure that you sear the sides, the top, just get it slightly brown, and then we'll transfer it back to the bowl, cook our onion. Get all them flavors in there, don't waste them. Appropriate footwear in the kitchen. All right, get a good sear on it. I've hit the side as well. All right, just let that get slightly brown. The raw sugar in that should caramelize that pretty quickly. Probably about 2 to 3 minutes each side, that's it. Whack that in your marinating tray for later. Got some mad juices and flavor in there now. A little bit more olive oil. Turn your heat down. I don't know what he's saying. Hey mate, put these in. Cook these bad boys off. Let's give them a light sear. Don't need to go too crazy. These are gonna be like a bed for the brisket. To that, you want to add your spices and your onion. That'll help to caramelize them. A little bit more oil, don't be afraid. Now we want to add about a tablespoon of tomato puree. With your leftover tomato puree, just roll it up, whack it in the freezer. You're good to go, don't waste it. That shit's expensive. Now for your key ingredient. Now, if you're going to use any other type of beer, other than Goldies, just get off my channel right now. You clearly have no taste buds. Right, that's been cooking away for a couple of minutes. Beer in. Let that reduce. Beer and onion, what a smell. Give it a bit of a reduce. That's also gonna be your moisture for when you're cooking your brisket, I hope. And I'm making shit up at the moment. I have done it before, but it's been a while. The best fun you can have in the kitchen, right? Brisket back in, lay away. Capture all them flavors, don't waste them. You worked hard prepping that. All right, last but not least, add about 250 ml of beef or chicken sole vegetable stock, whatever you want, in hot water. Arlo, what do you got?
Sauce.
You wanna put some sauce in?
Mm-hmm.
All right, mate. Is it in?
Mm-hmm.
All right, thanks, buddy. All right, beef stock in. We went beef. We're gonna keep it real today. I didn't mix that too well, did I? Oh, well, you get the point?
I remember, as I said, with your tomato puree, just put it in the freezer. Just pinch the top, good to go. Ready for a spag bol or anything you wanna cook later. This is probably the hardest part. We're gonna cover the brisket now and put it in the oven at 180 degrees for about 4 to 4.5 hours. uncovered. Last half hour we'll do uncovered.
And I don't care what anyone says, I go sun side down. Because I want the heat to go into my meat. Nice and tight. Pinch the sides. Do the same on the other side. And then be quick, because you don't want to lose all your heat. Whack that into your oven. Middle shelf. Good to go.
Silent all morning from Space Jam. Is this the track? Man, your ears have just had some soul, haven't they? Alright, the devil's back.
It's a beautiful day here in Wodonga. Got some sunshine. That's the best part about this dish. You did all the hard work last night and this morning when you woke up. Leave that bad boy in there. We're going to go for 4 hours. While that's cooking, I'm going to go around, do some shit, get some sunshine, get this pasty-ass skin. I've got some couple of friends coming around this afternoon with their kids to play with their little one. So an hour out, I'm going to make my potato salad, which takes 15 minutes, like slaw. It's going to be slaw with a difference, so slightly different to your regular slaw. And I'll do my beer bread, so stay tuned. Surely, I can't be the only one then. There's something other than the way I gave it to you. Don't even recognize the way you fuck me, do you? Gonna take America to bring me back. Car karaoke. I swear Arlo sits in the back and just goes, "Dad, shut up." It's like my bloody childhood dog. It's boss dog. G'day guys, welcome back. We're about an hour out. I think it's 11:45. About an hour and 15 minutes until I pull my brisket out. Went and got some sunshine in Albury, went and bought some presents for birthdays coming up and stuff. And now we're gonna get into making our beer bread. Disclaimer, I've never made this before. So this could go either way. This could end in beers or tears, as some people would like to say. So let's hope it ends up with the first one. A few ingredients you're gonna need for this. You're gonna need some self-raising flour. The best. Baking tray, a mixing tray, paintbrush, food paintbrush, butter, olive oil, and in here I just have 3 teaspoons of raw sugar and basically around 1-1.5 teaspoons of salt. Now I only have Himalayan pink rock salt because I'm fancy like that, but you guys can use whatever you want, any salt. I think ideally you would have just plain sugar and normal salt, but we've got to make do with what we have. So that's that. First thing we do is we add 3 cups, and a measuring cup obviously, 3 cups of self-raising flour. I'm gonna quite open this, try. It's first time. I've never baked, if I'm being honest. So this, like I said, this could go anyway. But this is a sifted self-raising flour. Whoa.
Much later.
One. Better edit this shit out. This is sloppy. Yeah, sorry about my edit yesterday. Well, I'm not sorry. I'm learning, so bear with me. 2 and a bit, probably.
So yeah,
that's
not
this one.
Oh, that's not.
A sloppy 3. 3 cups of self-raising flour in there. I bought a stand too, so we're bowling. And we're in 4K, so this should be shooting real differently. It should be clear. You should see my crow's feet and dimples. All right, to make this easy, like I said, I prepped this earlier. Your 3 teaspoons of sugar and 1.5 teaspoons of salt. Put that in there. Mix that bad boy around. Just gonna use a teaspoon. Mix it around. As I said, only the best. If you're putting Blackfish, Great Northerns, get off my channel, you know. That shit shouldn't even be used in cooking. Another key ingredient in here. Put your beer in there. Now, I'm gonna have a stab here and say I'm not gonna use all of it just yet. I think that I might wait. Try and mix my beer into my flour. And I'm gonna do it on the Weber. So I've got my pizza stone out there. I don't know what heat it's gonna get to. I've got no temp gauge. This is, we're going in completely blind here.
Mum will kill me with that music.
Turn it down! So I'm mixing it. As you can see, we're getting a super sticky consistency. I have no idea how I'm gonna get that off my fingers. Mix it up. We're gonna put, I'm gonna put 2 teaspoons, probably all I got left in there, of butter. I like one. 1 teaspoon of butter. 1.5, if I'm lucky. My partner uses that Natalex. Not into that. I like how easy it spreads, but the flavor, it isn't for me. She's a bit of a health freak. Get that full fat shit. Go hard. I'm gonna put this in the microwave for about 30 seconds. Don't ask me how many watts my microwave is, just melt it, all right? Okay, so I've seen Gordon Ramsay do this. So he just goes, throws a bit on the table, throws it. All right, he makes it look better, but. All right, I'm gonna do some powerlifting. I'm gonna put more on the table, I'm gonna worry. That shit stuck to my hand so bad. I'm gonna try and knead this. Why it's not coming together. I really hope it does. It's just blind cooking. You're going in completely blind here. It's really sticky. I hope we even get enough to put in the barbecue by the end of it. I don't know if that's a good consistency. Who knows? This could be an absolute disaster. And I'm not gonna edit it out. It's staying. It's staying in there. I laughed, someone turned around and told me that you could use Great Northern with this and make it bond a bit better. Oh man, I fucked up this kitchen. Crystal's gonna kill me. Line your baking tray. My hands are trash, so I forgot to do this before. I just have that shit all over my spray right now. Oh, it's turned out to be a disaster. Now you see why I don't bake. Right. I'm getting it, and I'm just dumping that in my tray. I'm looking like that dude out of the Empire Strikes Back. There's shit coming off my fingers. Crystal's gonna come in and just be like,
what?
Ugh.
What the fuck?
There is literally shit everywhere. I got this new Ryobi vacuum cleaner. It's lit. I like it because I love Ryobi 18 volt One Plus products. Loud as fuck though. Probably want to wear some hearing protection almost when you're using it. I digress. All right, we're back. That should took forever to clean up. But I'm not like everyone else. I'm not going to perfect something and then come on screen and try and look like a pro. I'm learning too, so the proof could be in the pudding. I don't know. I've melted my butter. I'm just gonna grab a paintbrush. I'm just gonna paint the top. Not really that it's formed of my beer bread, which I hope turns out to be bread. Now what I've done is I'll put my BBQ on for about 10-15 minutes on a high heat, and I'm gonna dial it back down to a medium heat once I get my bread in there. I'll put a pizza stone down because I don't wanna expose the bottom and burn the bottom of the bread. I don't have a trivet. I've had this BBQ for yonks. It's messy, it's over there smoking. But hopefully this works, so we'll go for a walk. As I said, bread, that's the final product. That's how it turned out. It's pretty sloppy. It's definitely not very aesthetically pleasing. Let's go out. Ooh. Anything could happen here. Hey, little man. All right, as I said, I've added on a medium to high heat. My trivet in there. Got my pizza stone, which is acting as a trivet. Let's hope. I'm gonna leave this in here for an hour. Let's hope that it works. I'll dial that back down to halfway. We'll go from there. I'll go a little over halfway. Got my basil growing. The weather in Wodonga here has just turned quite nice. I'm trying to get this lawn back. I planted some tomatoes. They've grown hardcore. Chilies, Got some more chilies, some capsicum. So hopefully it's a twofold. I can grow my own, I guess, herbs, tomatoes, and chilies, and I can block out Karen.
Fuck you, Dale! Fuck you!
We've done our beer bread. Now we're gonna do our slaw with a difference. Now, I don't have enough chives like I wanted, so I'm just gonna sort of improvise and use a bit of basil in my slaw. First thing I wanna do though is I wanna get my potato salad going, because that's gonna be something I'm gonna knock up concurrently to this, so be ready to go when we start cooking. Things you're gonna need for this is potatoes. I like to use the Baby Red Royale potatoes. I feel they boil a lot better. They cost bugger all. That's like a half kilo there for $3.50. So we're just crushing them. Big pot, which we're gonna add salt to. Chives, as I mentioned earlier, that'll go in the end, and sour cream, which I'll cover off for shortly. The slaw we're gonna make out of red cabbage. All I did was peel the outsides of the red cabbage off, wash the cabbage itself, and I've left that there. So we're gonna chop that up shortly and go through that. First thing I'm gonna do is get my spud ready to go. So simple this, you'll never buy potato salad again, and it tastes better, it tastes good, hot or cold. All you wanna do with your spuds is in half, and half again. Done, good to go. With these, just remember the smaller you cook them, the smaller you cut them, the quicker they're gonna cook. Just grab them, straight in your pan. Concurrently, you're gonna have your boiling water going, so you can just pour your water in over your potatoes when you're done. Last spud. Now what you wanna do with your spud is just add salt. Shitload of salt in there. For your slaw, pretty simple. Just slice your cabbage up. Reasonably fine, like that, and just break it up into your bowl. Repeat that process for the whole cabbage, and you're good to go. Just as an idea, I didn't even get through that whole cabbage. Half a cabbage, little cabbage, and my bowl's pretty full. So I'm gonna leave it at that. Then I just wanna, you can tear. Ideally you wanna tear basil, but I'm just gonna chop it because I want it real fine. I'm not sure if my guests love basil, or like herbs for general in that matter. He's a redhead, so who knows. Sorry, no. Just throw that in there. Now you wanna add a little bit of salt. Bit of pepper. Little splash of apple cider vinegar. This stuff's handy for making sauces, anything in general. Add a little splash. Pickle it. Sugar. Can't go wrong. And normally I'd put in chives, but I don't have enough because I've got to use this for my potato salad. So you would throw in a bit of chives, but we're not going to get to it at this point. All we want to do now is just add some yogurt, some Greek yogurt. Easiest way I found to stir things, two knives. Just toss away. That salt, pepper. Greek yogurt can be quite thick, so just be aware of it as you're stirring. And you're just gonna wanna set this aside when you finish. With some glad wrap again, leave it in the fridge, it'll go fine. The only final thing I would do is just adding a small touch of olive oil for flavor, depth, whatever you wanna call it, getting fancy. Final product. Wise man once told me, clean as you go. Gandhi. Could have been Jeff Stevenson. All right, you know when your spuds are almost good to go, so just pick a big one, and you see how it's starting to fall out of the skin. The skins basically start peeling away from the potatoes, you're ready to rinse. Tip out the excess. Be aware of that steam, it can be real hot. As I said, you want to leave your lid on so you can keep your heat inside your spuds. Oh, it's pretty simple. All we're going to do is add in our chives after we dice them up. Go real fine with your chives because you want them to go right through the salad.
lid off. Push them all to the bottom. Chives in. Now you want to add about half your sour cream. Just do it till you really have a good coverage. Sour cream obviously comes out hard. Don't stress. After you close that lid, it's going to melt through that very nicely. The salad should look like this. See, it's starting to melt now. All those chives and that sour cream. Now you want to add in your salt and pepper. Go nuts with it. Use that dirty spoon, save on dishes. Just stir it all together. So it all bonds. I'll probably put a little bit too much sour cream in mine. You can do it to taste. Just remember that you can add it in, you can't take it out once it's in. Normally you'd put spinach in this. Two handfuls of spinach, close the lid, let that steam down, and it'll just bond nicely and wrap up with the potatoes. But I've got heaps of kids coming around, so I don't want to fill this full of spinach and they won't eat it. Once you've done this, you won't ever go back to buying potato salad again.
Oh, guess it wasn't so much a disaster after all. So I'm informed that you can stick a knife in the top and it's not sloppy inside, you're good to go. I might pull that off. Have you even moved, mate?
So like I was saying, I guess it wasn't a disaster after all. Like, we won't know until we bite into it, but it looks pretty good to me. Oh, a bit burnt on the bottom. Crispy, but lesson learned there. Maybe give it 40 minutes in the oven. Buy a proper trivet. I'm not sure. I'm gonna give it a slice now. I can't really wait. Check out coming up. With the exception of the bottom, it looks alright, I think. Oh man, that's real hard. It's a bit doughy inside. Not too bad. I guess it's like damper. With some butter, we're dipped in gravy. That's actually gonna be real nice. Maybe a better trivet system. Some alfoil in the bottom. I don't know. Any ideas on my bakers out there? Let me know. My alarm's going off for my brisket. I haven't opened this once since it went in, so anything could happen here. It smells nice, like the smells in the house are amazing. Oh, that's hot, obviously. Wow.
Oh, that honestly smells amazing. Oh, yes.
It's spicy too.
I like it.
Right, so I'll take the brisket off, rest the joint, and then make a gravy. Thought I'd film this, it's gonna be a disaster. Gravy, you can make this as simple. Okay, now I'm just gonna make the gravy. You can make this as simple as you'd like. We like a chunky gravy, don't we, babe? Chunky gravy with, I like onion and stuff. Otherwise, I would, blend it. You can use a stick blender if you want to get that really silky smooth, but it's pretty simple. All you do is get those juices and everything out of the baking tray that you had. Don't touch them, just stir them, whack them back on the heat, bring it to the boil, add in a little bit of apple cider vinegar. That is how you make gravy. To taste, obviously, you can add some cornstarch if you want to make it thicker. I don't have any. Yeah, stir that out. Cook out the apple cider vinegar. We're on. Into a suitable bowl or pourer. Put the onions in there and everything. Get nice and chunky. Now what I'm gonna do, I forgot to mention before, is I'm gonna baste a few of these juices into my brisket and then wrap it in alfoil to rest. You just grab your onions out if you want. Delicious. Now I'm gonna wrap that in alfoil, let it sit for about 15 minutes.
Damn! How is it, babe? Good.
That's not going on YouTube.
Yeah, that's going on YouTube. Mate. Nutty digs it.
Good game.
What a sport.
This is how it turned out in the end. Pretty delicious. Gravy. With your onion.
That is legit delicious. I love it.
Get a hair of the brisket.
Oh, that's a
rubbish.
Oh.
That's it. It's a freestyle. The fuck you want for free?